Hey, what's up? It's your boy J Will coming back with another one, and we finally had the biggest update of the year so far since Madden 21 has come out. And Madden has finally came out with a large update that will hopefully fix their game and hope change the way that this game is being played for the years to come and the months to come. So first, what we have is the gridiron notes. We're going to go over the update notes and see what they're doing to fix this game, because Lord knows they need to. It's too many bugs, it's too many glitches, it's just too much that is wrong with this game and the state that it is in right now. And we're going to see if this update notes and if they're doing anything to change what they already have been doing. I would not be surprised if this update just brings more bugs. You know how Madden gets. They'll sometimes update one thing just to bring a whole bunch of bugs to another thing. So let's get into these launch notes and let's see what they're doing to help get this game right. So first we have the key highlights, which are coming with the new abilities added. They brought on some new abilities, gameplay fixes and tuning, and franchise and mud and yard bug fixes. So the biggest gameplay updates, they have a new run commit. Defenders with this ability will dominantly win run blocks when they correctly use the guess play adjustment to predict the run. Incorrect guess will result in a loss. This can be good, but it can also be bad, because when you run commit, you're guessing which way the runner is going, and sometimes, or usually, it hasn't been working so far. So we're going to see if they adjusted that so that when you choose the right side, you'll dominantly be able to get through the O-line and get to the runner, because running has been pretty powerful this year. I thought it was going to be a little weaker this year, but it's actually been pretty good. You're able to run the ball pretty frequently and pretty strong if you have the right playbook. So they have a new pass commit as well. Defenders with this ability will win pass blocks when they correctly use the guess play adjustment to predict a pass. Incorrect guesses will result in a loss, which is nice as well, because I actually use that feature and I don't think it's been working as good lately. I'll guess pass and it's almost like the DB doesn't even react good, or I'll tell them to go deep, or Y on the control stick or triangle, and then up, which will tell them to protect deep, and sometimes they don't even still go deep. They'll just play at the regular normal level and I'm telling them go deep. I'm guessing pass and they're still acting like they don't know what's going on. So hopefully they have that fixed. They have a new deflator. Defenders with this ability will cause increased fatigue penalties when tackling a ball carrier with a non-conservative tackle. They brought Enforcer, which is a new ability addressing the issue causing CPU control. Defenders with the Enforcer ability to use hit stick tackles too frequently as a result also cause more fumbles than intended. I haven't seen too much with the Enforcer. With the enforcer, you will fumble the ball, but with the CPU, they'll hit you hard and you'll be like, damn, they just hit me hard. But not too often have I fumbled the ball from that, so we'll see how that goes. Turnovers are already hard as it gets sometimes in Madden, especially in this one. You can read a coverage and be right underneath somebody with your linebacker, but just because he's a linebacker, they're not going to let you make the play, which is BS at times. So also they have ball carrier updated the QB slide functionality so that the double tap of the dive button will now always be slide when a single press will always be dive, with all in line with the non-QB ball carrier giving up functionality. So this means that they have changed the QB slide function, so instead of the quick tap, which we're all used to, and that in the LTRT, which I don't know why they got rid of that as well, but now we have to learn some new controls, which should have already been out with the new update, which is going to cause more people to lose games because we're not going to know about this stuff unless you just watch YouTube videos and update videos. You're not going to even know, and I didn't even know that they had switched LT to celebrating. That made me lose many games in Madden 21 this year because it's not an extra functionality like it used to be, where LT used to help you juke better or spin move better. Now you're just shaking. You're just, celebrating. And that's like, I didn't know that, and that made me lose a few games. So now we got to learn a new way to slide with our QB and with our non QB players, which is double tapping X now, no tapping X. That will do a regular dive, and I bet a lot of people are going to lose because they're not going to know this new controls when they first get into this new update. They're just not going to know that because it's not going to be in phased. I bet you it's not. So that might lose a lot of people some games, but hopefully you can like and share this video and you can get it out to some people so they won't lose Madden games because of some BS that Madden hasn't properly communicated to people. So what else they have? They have the modified the new journal animation to reduce oversteering. Fix the issue that would sometimes allow the QB to enter a tackle animation while attempting the slide, which could lead to fumbles. That's happened to me many times. I've been pressed the X button, and he's still running like I didn't tap X, and then I fumble the ball. So hopefully that's fixed. Fix an issue when a ball carrier would stumble and fall while having a collision with their legs. Seen to experience a little of that. Fix the issue where ball carriers were stumbling and falling too frequently when running through the line and colliding with their blockers. That has happened with me. Rashad Jones, or I believe that's his name, the running back for the Buccaneers. I don't know if he's fragile, if his strength is too low, but whenever I run with that guy, he stumbles and falls. Like, he has the weakest legs and doesn't have any type of calcium or milk in his body. He just falls every time I run with him. So hopefully that's fixed. They fixed an issue rarely causing the ball carrier to continuously run after scoring a touchdown. I haven't seen this one, so you're safe on that one, Madden. So hopefully that's fixed. Fix the quarterback pitching the ball with wrong hand on option plays. Now, how the hell do y'all do that? Come on now. That's probably killed many people before. It hasn't killed me yet, but I would be hot if I seen that happening. So hopefully that's fixed. Defensive coverage. Fix the issue allowing the bunch verticals, flanker motion snap, quick throw exploit versus cover 3 and cover 4. I did not even know about this exploit, but hopefully that is fixed. So now that we have read through some of the patch notes, I wanted to go into the game and see if any of these patches are actually applied to the game or are they just feeding us BS. So the first one we have right here is Gardner Minshew dropping back in the pocket and trying to run. And like I said earlier, if you don't know about tapping X not being the slide anymore, you will fumble the ball. And the guy I was going against clearly did not know that. He tapped X and he fumbled the ball with Minshew diving onto the ground. He did a full fade fumble right at JJ Watt. So you just knew that he did not know this new control, and that's just going to be a brain memorization thing. Like, a lot of people aren't even going to know to do that even when they do know, because their brain is telling them, oh, I only got to tap X. I only been tapping X for a month or two now, so I expect to only tap X. And like a lot of us think, isn't just going to up and just change some controls out of nowhere in an update. But they did. They changed the slide function of the game and the controls of sliding, and a lot of people don't know that, and he clearly didn't right there. Let's hop into the next clip. The next clip we have me pass committing, and this seems to be working just fine, and one of the few things that Madden did get right. I pass committed on this play and I was able to get the sack. You could say I got the sack because of just great coverage, but it looks like pass committing is working in Madden right now. Let's hop into the next clip. Now, in this next clip, this just makes me not even want to play Madden 21 altogether. It's like one of the easiest things you would think for someone like EA Sports, a big organization, to fix, and they just cannot fix this. It's the glare on the screen glitch, and I don't know what triggers this or what is the reasoning for this, but it has happened again. It hasn't happened to me in a while, but of course, right after a huge update, I'm experiencing the bright sunlight beam flashlight on my screen where I can't see none of my players or none of the field. How do y'all let this happen, Madden? This is why so many of your users and your consumers are so angry at you. You keep on releasing updates that are supposed to be fixing something, but it just adds more problems like this glare on the screen glitch. This is right after one of the biggest updates to date on Madden 21, and there is still this problem happening, man. This is very, very, very disappointing. And I just cannot see how y'all just continue to let this happen, man. Y'all gotta get this right and soon. Here's another clip of something EA claims they fixed, but they clearly denied, and that is wide open wide receivers dropping the ball. Like Gronkowski, one of the best tight ends in the league, got the surest hands, just dropping a wide open catch straight up the seam for a touchdown. Then you have Rashad Jones in the same game doing the same thing, dropping a wide open pass. It's like, how do you continue to let this happen, Madden? How do y'all continue to allow this to happen after a huge update where y'all emphasize y'all have fixed the catch animation? And it's clearly not fixed. Like, wide open receivers. We're talking about great receivers, great tight ends just dropping the ball. In this clip, we have one of the few game fixes that Madden actually did fix. And that is the user linebacker playing the ball better. Linebackers haven't been playing the ball as good. And as you can see on this play, I read the play well. I was on the receiver tight, and they gave me the animation to make the pick before this update. That hasn't been happening. You usually get mossed on if you got a linebacker in that situation. So I am happy and glad that Madden fixed that. But there are a lot of other issues with this game right now. Please let me know what y'all think about this update. I don't want to sound like I'm on a rant. I want to know what you all think, and if you all are seeing the same things, comment down below what you're experiencing and how you like the update so far. And this is all from one game in franchise mode, the mode that I believe many fans love, even though they put their attentions on other things like Ultimate Team and The Yard and Face of the Franchise, which those are some pretty fun game modes this year as well. But you let me know if the other game modes are tripping, like Franchise and Play Now or Online Play, because right now it's just looking very disappointing. Now, I didn't want to be the one to say this, but Madden brought this one. EA brought this one on themselves, man. We got to get this back trending. We got to get this back going, man. Like and share this video and share it on Twitter, Instagram. Share it with your friends that play Madden. Get this out there, because we can't keep on letting EA get away with this, man. We cannot keep letting them think they're releasing updates that are fixing the game when they're making the game more trash. And that's just simply what it is, man. EA doesn't put any effort into what they do, and they have shown it the most this year. One of the years that they were supposed to show us that they were coming with it, they have dropped the ball, man. Get NFL Drop EA trending. Like this video, sub to your boy, man. We coming with it.